Hi everyone, so today I want to talk a little bit about progesterone. So progesterone is a hormone that is predominantly produced in the second half of your cycle after you ovulate. So in the beginning of your cycle, you'll produce estrogen. Estrogen will help to build that follicle up, and once estrogen peaks, that's when LH, our luteinizing hormone, will surge, and once that happens, at least 24 to 36 hours after that, the egg will come out of the follicle, and that's ovulation. Once that follicle has ovulated, it then becomes something called the corpus luteum. And the corpus luteum is actually what helps us to produce progesterone in the second half of our cycle. And progesterone actually helps the uterus prepare for a possible pregnancy. So it's really important to make sure that you're actually building progesterone if you're trying to conceive. But there's other circumstances where we really need progesterone in terms of some conditions where we would actually need more progesterone. The first condition is PCOS. So in PCOS, we know that there can be a deficiency in progesterone, especially because cycles are irregular, and also what we see is there is this disconnection from the brain to the ovaries in terms of the production of hormones sometimes. So that's one condition, so PCOS. There's other things such as endometriosis, even heavy periods. That's when progesterone could be helpful too, to stop the bleeding. Maybe there's fibroids, things like that. So more estrogen dominant type of symptoms. So typically in the second half of that cycle, when we're producing progesterone from the corpus luteum, that's when we're going to actually test for progesterone. So they're usually about 7 days after ovulation. Typically, if you have a 14-day luteal phase, we want to get it 7 days, so kind of in between that luteal phase, to see what's happening with estrogen and progesterone at the peak of the luteal phase. And typically we want to look at both estrogen and progesterone to see what they're actually doing together. And if progesterone is low, or maybe estrogen is too high, then progesterone could be a treatment option to help to support that balance between estrogen and progesterone. So there's different types of progesterone that you can actually use. The first that I'm going to talk about is a progestin. So this is Depo-Provera or medroxyprogesterone. This is a synthetic form of progesterone. So it's actually known as a progestin. So when I'm saying synthetic, it's not a natural form. The body does kind of recognize it as progesterone, but it's not as similar as the progesterone you would create in your body. That's where bioidentical progesterone comes in. This is a type of progesterone that actually looks as similar as the progesterone in your body. So the natural form of progesterone that you create, the body recognizes bioidentical progesterone as similar to your own progesterone. It's actually also known as micronized progesterone, and it comes from wild yam. So this is a herb where they actually extract the medicinal property that looks like progesterone, and they use that to create suppositories. Other forms of micronized progesterone are brands like Prometrium, Crinone, and Endometrion. So today what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually show you what a bioidentical compounded form of progesterone looks like and how to use the suppositories, since this is a question that I'm getting often. So let's take a look. I just have it right here. All right. I'm just going to open up the suppositories. So typically when it's a compounded form of progesterone and it's a suppository, so I'm talking about a vaginal suppository, you'll want to actually store it in the fridge. So these are what the suppositories look like. So they just come in this like pack of molds, and as you can see, the progesterone suppository is actually inside there. And so what you'll do is you'll store this in the fridge, this whole packet, and it just comes in a box that you can store it in. And how you actually remove the progesterone is you kind of just like hold your finger at the very bottom here and kind of pinch it. I just took this out of the fridge, so it's a little bit cold. You can also wait a little bit, but basically you just want to kind of pop it out there. There we go. Okay. It's been a while since I've done this. So, and then this is the applicator. So basically the applicator just looks like this. Some pharmacies will give you an applicator. Some pharmacies, from what I'm being told from patients, aren't getting applicators. So you have to use your fingers, but this is typically what you should be receiving. And so you'll just like insert the suppository into the applicator here, and then this is what you'll kind of insert into the vaginal canal. So I'm just going to put this back. So this usually takes just like maybe a day or two to get used to, but as you can see, the suppositories aren't difficult to use. It's more so just getting used to actually using the applicator or your fingers or whatnot. Okay. And so just to recap, like the progesterone suppositories, they are bioidentical progesterone. So it is just as similar as the progesterone in your own body. And again, in PCOS, it can help to regulate the cycles. In endometriosis, it can also help with reducing that estrogen or opposing that estrogen. And then also it can decrease heavy menstrual bleeding or spotting. So yeah, if you have any questions about progesterone, just let me know in the comments. I'd be happy to answer any questions you have. Take care.